Hi, it's Tony Jones here, a.k.a. Tony Prepster, here at North Central College in Naperville. I'm here with girls head coach Dan Iverson. How you doing, coach?
Doing very well, thanks.
All right. Great program, historic program. He's one of the great coaches in the state of Illinois and in the country. He won numerous state championships, defending state girls champion. What kind of goals do you have this season for your team?
Well, we always start off with setting our targets fairly high. So, we like to go back and win the conference championship, regional sectional state championship. We like to go back to Portland, do better than we did last year, 15. We know none of that will be easy, though. So.
Well, speaking of, let's start with the state first. It's going to be, as you know, Illinois is one of the top states for girls across country. You got some good teams biting at your heels this year. Lindbergh West is one. You got to take care of state business first. Is that a paramount goal?
It is. Certainly. We're not going to do anything to diminish the importance of the state championship. We can't, in fact. Lombard West brings in enough that, with the transfer they got, we'll have our hands full just worrying about them, but then you get Palatine in the mix, and they develop really nicely in track, and, and then who knows? Teams like Downers Grove South got a couple kids under 11 coming back, and, it'll be Geneva's good. They're ranked nationally right now. That'll be interesting.
Awesome, Coach. We were actually filming the practice earlier this morning. You guys start pretty early, like 7 a.m. most days.
Yep.
Is there a reason why you start so early with your program?
Yeah, heat. Although that doesn't really matter, I guess, today. It's 65 right now, but still. Generally speaking, it's much nicer to start at 7 because we're done by 9, and usually that's where the temperature gets uncomfortable. And so you just want to get it done before then.
Provide your kids with less excuses, too, like, I got a job or I want to have some fun during the day as well.
we get kids who ask us about the 7 o'clock start, and I always say, if you prefer to run at, 10 o'clock in the morning, just let me know. But I usually look at the temperature right around then and say, no, that's okay, coach. We'll go early.
How many girls do you have in your program in most years you start out with during the season?
We're right around 100. We've been as high as 110, 115. Last year we were like at 90. So it kind of fluctuates in there.
How many coaches do you have in the coaching staff to handle those kinds of numbers?
This year we have 4. It's the most we've ever had, so I'm pleased with that. We normally have 3. And so that's a little bit of a challenge because, we take 4 buses to Detweiler, and with only 3 coaches, one bus has no coach on it. So, stuff like that is an issue. But really, I'm very pleased to have 4 this year.
Yeah, we noticed earlier this morning some of the, it's not new, but more functional strength training has been incorporated, even though distance in the past has been like, hey, let's line up and run, maybe some stride outs after practice. Now you guys have a whole practice dedicated to functional movement, getting strong. Is there a reason why you guys changed different philosophies over the past few years?
Dave Gracie, the boys coach, and I really have worked a lot together over the years. And together we've kind of come to a real different understanding of how the human body works, how to prevent injury, and how to train, really. And it's something that I would never, doing a practice like you just watched was something that coming out of college I would never have done.
Mm-hmm.
But it's something that has been an evolutionary process with me, is teaching kids how to make the right movements within the running form, and then learning how to incorporate that into practice, where their heart rate's up the entire time, they're doing functional movements that are specific to distance running. It's very limited. You saw we don't do a ton with backward weights, but we do a little bit, and then it's all very specific, and we're learning all the time, both Dave and I, it's sort of an exciting process because we, I think, had pretty good results with regard to injury prevention so far.
Mm-hmm. Right, exactly.
It's a very important part of what we do.
Great. I noticed you have the boys. You're coaching the boys as well during this process. Are you guys a combined program or
during the year? No, not at all. During the year, we don't go to any of the same meets. We see each other in practice because we start at the same time and we finish at some of the same times. But we don't see each other much at all during the year. But during a little bit later, it was in the summer. We're very much a combined program. Okay. You know, we have the same route run. We for our long run on Monday. We do a combined yoga workout on Tuesdays. We do the same workout on Wednesdays for our hard days. You just saw what Thursday looks like, and tomorrow you know, we have a game day on Friday that everyone plays. So it's a distance running game of some kind.
Oh, you take a day off of like just the stresses of running, just have fun?
Well, we do. Like last week, we did a photo scavenger run. So the kids had a one cell phone and my text and my number, and so they went out all over the place and were looking for schools, statues, parks, and they had to take pictures with their group in the different places and texting. I got probably like 200 texts during the course of the run.
Oh wow!
But then they got points for however many pictures they got of different parks and different places. So it was a run. I mean, it was, you know, they got in a run for an hour. They were out there running for an hour, but they were screwing around and doing it. So it was probably not the highest quality run we've ever done, but it was a good recovery day.
Awesome. That's fun right there. So. All right, let's cover one more thing. Yeah. I noticed that when I look at results, just back to the team aspect, I guess, your splits, how do you year after year after year have gotten your team to run like just so compact, like say at the state meet, like a 20-second split? I think when you hit like a 9-second split, right?
Yeah, we've been like under 10 seconds a couple times.
How do you do that? Do you try not, do you just don't have a top runner, maybe a top 5 runner, like a, you know, how do you able to develop something so awesome as that?
Well, you know, I think to some extent you have to, we've had some years where we've been over a minute, 1-5, but that was when we had like Shannon Phelan, and she was
right,
you know, getting second in the state, or at least Lisa Bonastale was blowing that out of the water for a while. You know, and if I had Maddie Perez, I imagine I'm splitting the book a little bit too, you know.
Right.
But you know, so you have to sort of let what's on your team come to you in terms of what you have. But indeed, where there has to be a sweet spot up there somewhere where you have a pretty tight pack of people who are used to training together, who are used to pushing each other, who really like that. And that's part of managing the competition that you have on the team, you know, and making that a positive thing, not a negative thing. You know, I mean, kids are working hard for spots. I mean, there's no doubt. I mean, the reality is we've got seven kids that will go to the line at state, but we've got 100 on the team. So we need those 93 who aren't on the team to be as good as they possibly can be to push those seven that end up making it. And by the time they do that, I just think that they're used to train together, used to run together. You know, we don't try to get a under 10 seconds split every year. That's not necessarily a target, because that's not always appropriate. I mean, honestly, sometimes, I mean, one year we had a 10-second split, but we were all, this was like in 2002 or whatever, but we were all from like 150th to 165th. You want a 10-second split up somewhere good, you know, and so that's kind of what we're after, is to develop that group as high up as we possibly can, and the way we try to create a sort of chain, where 65 pushes on 64, and 32 on 31, and, you know, then eventually 10's pushing on 9, and 8's pushing on 7, and you know, sometimes they switch, but they all get better, so that's what we want.
Awesome. Awesome, Coach. So what you going to do with yourself during this next week and a half or so?
I got a lot of work to do. You know, every year, you know, you go through every workout, make sure that you tailor it. So right now I'm in the process of going through all the things we did last year and thinking what worked right, what didn't work right, and kind of then shuffling things up where I need to be shuffled. And that'll take a lot of time. And it always does. I mean, that's been kind of a summer-long project, but I've got a lot of stuff to do in terms of just making those adjustments, getting ready for our camping trip, which is the first day of practice. And
where do you guys go for that?
Near Macomb, Illinois. That's where I grew up. And so we'll go down there, get some trail running in, sit around the fire a little bit, talk about what we want to do for the year.
Your buddy Hardy, Rob Harvey's from that area too, right?
He's from just north of Quad Cities.
Rob Harvey, Wheaton, one of those South coach, girls coach.
Yeah.
Awesome. Awesome, Coach. Thank you for your time.
Oh, yeah. My pleasure. Anytime.
Dan Iverson, Naperville North, girls coach, head coach, Tony Jones. Thank you.